Welcome to part 7 of Blogger plus AdSense tutorial series. You are going to learn how to create a new Google AdSense account for Blogger website, the steps to add a new site in Google AdSense sites list, and the tutorial to submit website review application to Google AdSense. You may skip to each timestamp if you know how to create a new Google AdSense account. Since this is a full steps-by-steps tutorial series, I will show you how to set up a simple Blogger site and get Google AdSense approval. Let's dive in right now. It's been 4 days since all my blog posts have been published on my Blogger website. All my 17 Blogger posts and the website URL is appearing on the Google search results now, which means that Google already crawled and indexed all my content after I submitted the URLs of these posts in Google Search Console. This is my Search Console page, and it shows that my content has a coverage status of submitted and indexed. My quota to inspect any URL is finished today, but it will be refreshed tomorrow. Let's move on to the Blogger dashboard. All important pages were also published a few days ago, but they are not indexed by Google yet. Besides, this blog has 14 views in all time, but it is still okay to get Google AdSense approval. So now click the Earnings button on the Blogger sidebar, then you can open a new Google AdSense account by clicking the orange button here. For your information, you don't have to be eligible first to open an AdSense account after an update in 2020. Therefore, I created a new Blogger website to illustrate the latest tutorial to create a Google AdSense account in 2021 without grayed out sidebar. You can create a Blogspot domain Blogger website by clicking the triangle symbol on the upper left side. Choose the name and URL for the Blogger site. Press Save to proceed, and click here to enter the Blogger Earnings tab. Click this Create AdSense Account button to proceed. Inside the sign up page, you can see the Blogger website URL is filled in here already, so don't click the box beside I don't have a site yet. You may select any of these customized help. For the payment country or territory, you have to choose it wisely because you can't change this country anymore once your Google AdSense account is created. Simply review the terms and conditions of Google AdSense, and click the box beside I have read, and accept the agreement. Then press Start using AdSense to create a Google AdSense account. Now a Google AdSense account is created and opened successfully with a clickable, non-grayed out sidebar, and you can click on Sites and Account. If your Google AdSense account is not looking like this now, you may refer to my tutorial post and learn the ways to permanently delete a Google AdSense account and create a functional Google AdSense account like what I'm showing here in part 7 of BAT series. The link is provided in the description box. The first thing to do is to press the Enter Information button to fill up personal details here. Under Customer Info, you are given two types of Google AdSense account to choose. These two types are Individual Account and Business Account. Same as the payment country, you can't change the AdSense account type after you submit this personal information. Normally it is better to choose an individual account type as your AdSense account. After that, fill in your full name and address by typing your info down here. It is best for you to fill in all the real information about you in this section, but actually my Google AdSense account was created using a false identity and address. I didn't use my real identity back then because I was dealing with a duplicate AdSense account issue before, but my website still received Google AdSense approval. You can change your name and address after your website is approved by Google AdSense. I don't recommend this method unless you are rejected with a duplicate AdSense account issue, and Google AdSense keeps asking you to close down another AdSense account. You may fill in the phone number, it is optional to some countries, but it could be mandatory too. Press Submit to update your personal information. If this page appears, then AdSense needs to verify your phone number, and you have to fill in your phone number in order to finish the setup of your Google AdSense account. Remember to add a plus symbol in front of your phone number, and you can choose to receive verification code from Google using either text message or voice call. Press the Send button and wait for the verification code. Then fill in the 6 digits code and press Submit. Now Google AdSense got my info, and the next step is to connect your websites to AdSense. Click the Let's Go button inside the third box, and click the Request Review button. This is the way to create a Google AdSense account and submit the Blogger website review request to AdSense. You may skip to review this page. You can see the Blogger website is now getting ready to be reviewed by Google AdSense. Let's move on to the Blogger dashboard. Your earnings tab inside the Blogger dashboard will be showing like this if your Blogger website is fully connected to Google AdSense. After the page is refreshed, it shows that AdSense is reviewing my site. So now all we need to do is just wait for the reply from Google AdSense and see whether AdSense approves or rejects my Blogger website. But actually this blog is going to be rejected by Google AdSense with valuable inventory, no content, or Google served ads on screens without publisher content issues. I will talk about these AdSense policy violations in the next 2 or 3 parts of the Blogger plus AdSense tutorial series. For those who already have an activated Google AdSense account, you can learn how to add a website to Google AdSense sites list within the next few minutes. If you have a separate account on Blogger and Google AdSense, you can invite the other Google account with Google AdSense as an admin on your Blogger website. Let's move to settings on Blogger dashboard, click Invite More Authors, and type the Google account here using Gmail address. Press Save to proceed. Log into the Gmail of another account, click this email and press Accept Invitation. Click here to sign in and accept the invitation. The invited Google account is an author, but not an admin. Move back to the Blogger settings page and refresh it. Click Blog Admins and Authors under the Permissions section and change the status of this account from author to admin. Refresh the Blogger settings page of another Google account and the sidebar is changed now. Proceed to the Blogger Earnings tab. It shows that I have an AdSense account already, and all you need to do is click the Connect AdSense button. Don't worry about AdSense doesn't know about your blog issue, just copy the Blogger URL inside this bracket. Inside the site's list of your Google AdSense account, click the Add Site button on the upper right side and paste the Blogger URL here. Click this button to save and continue. Then click this button again to request Google AdSense to review my Blogger website. So now Google AdSense account is connected to the Blogger website, and AdSense is reviewing it to determine whether my website is eligible to receive Google AdSense approval or not. I heard someone say you have to copy AdSense code and add it between the head of your Blogger theme, but actually you don't have to do it as long as the earnings tab is looking like this with a message your AdSense account is connected and so on. You may check the ads.txt file on Blogger website and check whether the format is similar to what I showed you here. By the way, it may take a few days to 2 weeks for Google AdSense to complete the review of any website application and reply with either Google AdSense approval or rejection. Most of the time is rejection. So let's wait for a few days until I receive a reply from Google AdSense. Apart from that, for anyone who wants to monetize a Blogger website by getting Google AdSense approval for Blogger, you have to sign up a Google AdSense account from the earnings tab on Blogger dashboard. You can't create a Google AdSense account for your Blogger website directly through the official website of AdSense. It could be troublesome to get Google AdSense approval when you fail to create an AdSense account through Blogger dashboard. But Google AdSense recently canceled this restriction, and you may create a Google AdSense account for Blogger website directly on their website, so you are free to sign up for an AdSense account for Blogger website through Blogger dashboard or AdSense official website without any issue anymore. That's all for part 7 of Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. Feel free to ask me something in the comment section if you still have any doubts about Blogger and Google AdSense approval. You are going to learn how to fix valuable inventory, no content, and valuable inventory, under construction issues on Blogger website, and get Google AdSense approval in part 8 of the BAT series. For your information, Google AdSense changed the policy violation name of valuable inventory, no content to Google served ads on screens without publisher content, since October 2021. So the next part of BAT series is also a tutorial to fix AdSense policy violation, Google served ads on screens without publisher content in 2021. By the way, once my YouTube channel has 1,000 subscribers and reaches 4,000 hours of watch time, I will pick one subscriber of this YouTube channel and award you something. If you are the lucky one, I will help you to get Google AdSense approval free. Just make sure you click the subscribe button, leave a like and comment in any Google AdSense related video to be eligible for this lucky draw. Before we move on to the next YouTube tutorial video, tell me which factors you think are the most important factor to get Google AdSense approval on a website. A. Daily traffic. B. Number of posts. C. Website theme. Or D. Content quality. Leave your choice in the comment section, and I will create a video to specifically talk about the most popular option after the end of this Blogger Plus AdSense tutorial series. You are the one to decide which content you want to see, so choose it wisely. Click the watch list on your left to watch the next part of VAT series, or click the watch list on your right to learn more about Google AdSense and the ways to fix policy violations on Google AdSense. Goodbye and have a nice day.